SpaceX is working towards transforming humans into a multi-planet species. The company is developing a fully reusable Starship capable of performing long-duration voyages to Mars. Engineers are working on the creation of a massive stainless steel spacecraft that could transport 100 passengers, and a super-heavy rocket that could propel 100 tons of cargo to orbit. Not only is SpaceX taking on the challenge of developing a fully reusable interplanetary launch vehicle, it is also creating a production system at the Starbase factory located in Boca Chica Beach, Texas, to manufacture hundreds of Starships within the next 10 years. SpaceX has performed multiple high-altitude test flights of Starship prototypes since 2019, and is preparing to conduct the first-ever flight to outer space. However, the company is facing delays to obtain federal approval to continue launching from Boca Chica. The U.S. Federal Aviation Administration is currently performing an environmental assessment of the Starbase launch site to ensure that spaceflight operations do not affect the local wildlife and communities. A portion of Boca Chica Beach is a U.S. National Wildlife Refuge and a historical landmark. The FAA must complete the assessment in order for SpaceX to apply for a Starship flight license. The administration has delayed the assessment's completion multiple times. It has been conducting the review for around 9 months. The latest target date to complete the assessment is April 29. The planned April 29, 2022 release date will allow the FAA to review the final programmatic environmental assessment, including responses to comments, and complete consultation and coordination with agencies at the local, state, and federal level. All consultations must be complete before the FAA can issue the final PEA, the FAA stated. SpaceX is facing a new hurdle though. The U.S. Army Corps of Engineers suspended a SpaceX application that proposes to expand the Starbase facility because it claims the company did not provide some information it requested. The application process will resume when they submit more information. Texas Governor Greg Abbott plans to fight for SpaceX federal approval to launch Starship from Boca Chica. What I am going to do if Biden interferes with the ability of SpaceX to launch from Boca Chica. I am going to be working every step of the way to make sure that they are going to be able to launch from Boca Chica, said Abbott, according to Rio Grande Guardian News. Governor Abbott shared he conversed with SpaceX's Starbase Director of Operations, who leads Starship operations. We heard the vision from SpaceX director himself about what they are working on, and our job is to make sure they are able to achieve their vision, said Abbott. And we will be working with him very closely, every step of the way in Boca Chica for the future of SpaceX. We want that future and that vision to come from Boca Chica, from Brownsville, Texas. SpaceX founder Elon Musk's vision to return humanity to the moon and launch the first astronauts to Mars continues in spite of challenges. The company is still conducting ground tests with Starship Super Heavy rocket prototypes at Boca Chica, and continues to manufacture more test vehicles at the Starbase rocket factory. SpaceX also started the construction of a Starship launch tower at NASA's Kennedy Space Center to support crewed missions in Florida, which could also enable the company to proceed with Starship development testing amid the Texas approval delays. I am inspired by curiosity. That is what drives me. So let us expand the scope and scale of consciousness, so that we may aspire to understand the universe, says Musk. The SpaceX Starship offers extraordinary potential benefits for the exploration and development of space by both the public and private sectors. It will enable many new commercial space ventures, as well as dramatically lower the costs and raise the frequency of scientific missions that will provide amazing new knowledge about our universe and home planet. Its relatively clean environmental footprint, the large savings it offers U.S. taxpayers as a means of transport for government programs and missions, and its ability to rapidly and regularly deliver satellite constellations and payloads to orbit, will enhance national security, increase high-paying jobs in the space sector, and propel American space leadership far ahead of any global competitors. Therefore we, the undersigned organizations, strongly urge the Federal Aviation Administration and other federal agencies to provide full approval to SpaceX to begin orbital test flights of the Starship at the earliest possible date. The Federal Aviation Administration has announced that the completion of a crucial environmental assessment, SpaceX needs to begin orbital class Starship launch attempts out of South Texas. Recently, a group of 14 space advocacy organizations published a joint statement, urging rapid U.S. government approval of SpaceX's Starship test flights. And now Texas government also supports SpaceX, and put pressure on FAA to complete environmental assessment as soon as possible, or approval for Starship first orbital launch from Boca Chica, Texas. Commenting on the initiative, Mars Society President Dr. Robert Zubrin said, "The organizations that have come together to make this statement represent every point of view within the space community. Whether one's priority is settling Mars, developing space commerce, exploring the moon, assuring national security, or gaining new knowledge of the Earth, the planets, or the universe, we all agree that it is vital that this program be allowed to move forward. There may be many more hurdles like this, that SpaceX and others seeking to open the space frontier will face, but this statement shows that, the often fractured movement of space advocates can come together, to help when it really counts." During a recent TED interview, SpaceX founder Elon Musk said the goal to colonize Mars will require 1,000 reusable starships, to launch megatons of cargo in order to create the first self-sustaining city before the year 2050. SpaceX aims to manufacture starships at a rate of one per month by the end of 2022. "We have built a production system for Starship. We're making a lot of ships and boosters," Musk shared. "We are currently expecting to make a booster, and a starship, initially roughly every couple of months and then, hopefully, by the end of this year one every month," he said. Musk believes it is important to have a high production rate, because it enables engineers to move on rapidly to test the next prototype after a failure. "A high production rate solves many ills. If you have a high production rate, you have a high iteration rate. For pretty much any technology whatsoever, the progress is a function of how many iterations do you have, and how much progress do you make between each iteration," Musk told reporters in 2020. "If you have a high production rate, then you have many iterations. You can make progress from one to the next." Long term, SpaceX aims to build at least one Starship each week to achieve building the fleet of 1,000 Starships by 2050. At that rate, the company would achieve building around 100 starships every 2 years. In 2020, Musk said the Starbase factory assembly line will eventually be capable of manufacturing a starship every 72 hours. Musk's plan is to launch a fleet of around 100 starships to orbit, to send passengers and cargo every 2 years to the Red Planet. The orbits of Earth and Mars align approximately every 26 months, for a shorter duration voyage of around 6 to 8 months. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.